Including Timbuktu, Tel Aviv and Baghdad, is now back home, and I've added some new family members to it. This is where the project needs to be, because only here can it truly come to life in the way originally intended, as a voice in the national conversation about the roles, rights and responsibilities of Muslims in the UK. Against the backdrop of ISIS Jihadi John and Jihadi Brides, this exhibition presents what I like to refer to as the people of the silent majority. Muslims who contribute and elevate society and not destroy it. We need role models more than ever. People who inspire us in every walk of life, whether they are artists or politicians, royalty or servants, children or adults.
This is the art of integration. Integration, not assimilation. I think one of the things that is really exciting about the project and about potentially particularly this part of the project is the way in which we try to counter those discourses which see Muslim as other, and really just on the basis of everyday life. And when you go downstairs, if you haven't been already, and you see Peter's wonderful pictures, you get a very strong sense of people going about their daily life, living in ordinary ways, people who share the hopes and dreams that everyone does, and people who are British citizens too, for the most part, and who are proud of their British identity and expressing that in the same ways as everyone else.
Images that can melt the toughest of hearts and the deepest of prejudices, and images that inspire. Many of you will know that how dear to His Royal Highness's heart is the need to build bridges between communities, particularly faith communities, to challenge that most pernicious myth of the clash of civilizations. So it is my great pleasure to convey His Royal Highness's good wishes for the exhibition, in which of course he features, and to thank all of you involved, particularly Peter, for your inspiring and wonderful work. Thank you. Thank you.